Welcome back, guys. So in this video, we are going to understand variance and standard deviation for any probability distribution table or random variable, you can say. So I've taken an example of tossing a coin two times, and the random variable is number of heads. So number of heads in tossing a coin two times can be 0, 1 or 2. You can get 0 heads, that means head will never come. Both the times, first and second, tail comes. X can be 1, first one can be head, second can be tail, and vice versa. X can be 2, both the times you will get head. Probability for X equal to 0 will be 1 by 2 into 1 by 2, because first time tail comes 1 by 2, second time tail comes 1 by 2, they are independent events. So 1 by 4. Probability for one head will be first head, second tail, and first tail, second head. So 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 into 1 by 2. So 1 by 4 into 2, 2 by 4. I am not simplifying it on purpose because I want the same denominator everywhere. Probability for two heads will be 1 by 2 into 1 by 2. First is head, second is head. The probability is 1 by 2. Into 1 by 2, which is 1 by 4. You can check, the sum of probabilities will be equal to 1. We can say summation of px is always 1 in probability distribution, that we covered in a video a few videos back. Okay, so this we have understood very well. Now let's calculate the mean. So we understood in the previous video, mean is summation of x px. So 0 into 1 by 4 plus 1 into 2 by 4 plus 2 into 1 by 4. So 2 by 4 plus 2 by 4. So 4 by 4 equal to 1. So mean is 1. That means on average you can expect 1 head. Okay. So mean is 1. Now we will understand what is variance and standard deviation. Variance is the measurement of how different values of x differ from the mean. Standard deviation also has the same explanation. The only difference is that standard deviation is square root of variance. Because while finding variance, you have to square the difference every time. The reason for squaring the difference is that if you don't square the difference, then you may get zero difference if random variable value is same unit smaller or greater than the mean. Let me give an example. Suppose mean in a certain case is suppose 2, and random variable possible values are suppose 1, 2 and 3. Okay, assume that probabilities are same. So now for difference of 2, for difference of 2, difference of 2 and 1, 1 is the difference. If you do 2 minus 1, plus 2 minus 2, 0, plus 2 minus 3, minus 1. Okay, and no matter what you divide here, this will become 0. Okay, so to avoid this problem, we want to know the absolute difference. Absolute difference can be taken in two ways. One way is that you take the mod, but mod is slightly complicated, especially when you write programs and when you want to understand using some tool, okay? It's slightly different, okay? Slightly difficult also. So we, for convenience, simply square it. So we square the differences, we multiply the probability to each difference, square, then we add them, we take the weighted mean of that. So I will write the formula here, where x will be equal to x minus mu whole square into corresponding probability to take the weighted average. Weighted average of differences. Weighted average of differences. Okay, so this is very important to understand how it works. Okay, and summation of that for each x value you have to do it. Okay, so for this one, 0 minus 1 whole square into 1 by 4. 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1 whole square into 2 by 4, 2 minus 1 whole square into 1 by 4, and so on. Okay. So before going there, I will just rewrite the formula and tell you that variance has two formulas. This is fundamental formula, and then there is another formula which you can use for convenience. Okay, so summation, you expand it, x square plus mu square minus 2 mu x into px, which is equal to summation of x square px plus summation of mu square px, okay, minus 2 mu x summation minus summation of 2 mu x px. Okay, so we get summation of, now summation of x square px. So we know that expectation of x is x px summation. Similarly, expectation of x square will be how much? That will be summation of x square px. Suppose somebody is asking expectation of log x, that will be summation of log x px and so on. So whatever function appears here, the same function into weighted average, summation of that will be the expectation of that. So this quantity is some expectation of x square. Okay, because expectation of anything is summation of same thing into px. And now this one will be mu square is a constant, you can take it out. Okay, minus 2 mu is constant. So expectation of x square plus, this is 1 by definition, here I have shown you here, okay, mu square minus 2 mu, and this is how much, x px summation, ex or mu, same thing only, so mu. So mu square minus 2 mu square is minus mu square. So expectation of x square minus mu square, and mu square is expectation of x whole square. Okay, so this is a very important formula. Okay, so I can write it here now. Okay, where x is equal to summation of x minus px, sorry, x minus mu whole square px, or expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square. So both the formulas you can apply. Second one is more convenient to apply. Okay, so now using these two formulas, I will find the where x here. Okay, okay, so mu was 1 here. Okay, so now let's find where x. So summation of this, okay, so 0 minus 1 whole square, so 1 square into px is 1 by 4 plus 1 minus 1 whole square is 0, doesn't matter what else is there, x minus 1, 2 minus 1 whole square, so 1 square into px is 1 by 4, so we get 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4, 1 by 2, okay, that's using the first formula. If you use the second formula, so expectation of x square, that will be summation of x square px minus expectation of x whole square. Summation of x square px. So x square is 0. So 0 square. So 0 only plus 1 square into 2 by 4 plus 2 square into 1 by 4 minus expectation of 1. So 1 square. 2 by 4 plus 4 by 4 is 6 by 4 minus 1. So 2 by 4, 6 by 4 minus 1 is 2 by 4. So 1 by 2. You can see we got the same answer. Okay? And standard deviation is simply under root of var x, which is 1 by root 2 in this case. Okay? So I hope you are very clear with variance and standard deviation now. This is how it works. And I also told you both the formulas, the derivation and what this actually is. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video. In the next video, we will solve more problems related to probability distribution, variance and standard deviation. Till then, please subscribe our channel, please like our video and share the video. Thank you so much.